So, namaste people, good evening. I am Daksh. I'm the founder of Blub World magazine. Blub World basically works for a simple focus to find out teenagers who are doing inspiring work in their life and sharing their inspiration with other teens. To put it simply, it's teens inspiring teens. Till date, we have showcased nearly 300 such teenagers from all across the world, and we are continuing to do so every month in print, online, and on different media available to us. And since this lockdown began, we started an activity called the Blub World Web Talks, which is basically a platform for school leaders to share their opinions, ideas, perceptions, observations about how is education innovating, and typically school education. We are trying to create industry white papers focused on the K-12 sector, which is simply schools. And this activity is one of the forerunners of those research initiatives that we are taking right now. So I'm very happy to welcome all of you to the Blub World Web Talks 61st episode. In the last 60 episodes, more than 650 school leaders have already participated on this platform, shared their opinions and ideas, and we've showcased some of the best ideas in the magazine and in other social media. You can actually go right now on Blub World, on different media, and actually check those ideas and even experiment those within your institutions and share those observations with us. So this very lockdown right now has changed school education in a completely, what we can say, drastic and at the same time exponential way. And two spectrums, wo hum logon ke liye shayad blessing bhi raha aur kahi kahi jagah bane bhi raha, because the schools responded to it very quickly. Bahut jaldi innovative practices, technology accept ho gayi, but because we were not very well trained, we were not very well equipped, us training ke bina un online classes mein bahut jaldi fatigue bhi aa gaya. But that fatigue has also now gone, because ab hum trained ho gaye, we have used tech very well, and it has now typically ingrained in our DNA. So today we'll try to know from all of you, what do you think on how is school education changing? For a simple reason, the way we all understand the word school and the definition of a school, the way we know it, has already been obliterated. It does not exist anymore. Now the institution that you'll be reopening would need a new definition, including its financial model, its operational model, its sanitization and safety model, and even the in-class teaching model. So we'll be typically looking at a lot of innovations getting inducted in a very small span of time. So let's see, what do you think and what are your opinions on this? So I would now like to invite the first guest for today, Ms. Neema Jain, Principal Priyadarshini, Nag School, Nagpur. Ma'am, over to you. You can unmute your audio.
Yeah, hi everyone. Good evening. Namaste. So, basically, I'm a tech lover. So, you know, maybe this era is changing for the people like, you know, gadget freak people like me, or students who are in this era who talk about gadgets, who talk about so many other things, right? Which we were unaware and they were aware about. So today when we are training our teachers, we're going online for the classes and things like that. I think personally that it's going amazing. I mean, I don't want to use this word new normal, because digital world was already inside the schools, right? Whether we talk about any digital platform which we were using inside the schools as a teaching aid. What are we doing today is that we are virtually inside the houses of the children. When my teacher started taking the classes, and you know, we actually entered and the children entered, and I really felt that my teachers are going inside, virtually inside the houses of the children and actually teaching, you know. So, and children were so excited. We just started a day back, and children were very, very excited to see their teachers. See, whatever comes and goes, you know, the bond between the teacher and the child will never go away. So be it virtually or be it physically being present, I think this bond is never going to end. So this is number one, that the bond will never end. So come what may, right? Secondly, I would also put stress on that education must go on. Learning must go on. Anyways, it can be any medium. Where, like, you know, there are people who are sending videos. There are people who are sharing, the teachers or the schools are sharing videos, ready-made videos, or the teachers are making the videos and they are making it and they are posting it to their children. Whether that is the thing or the teachers take the classes online. So I think where there is a way to learn, where there is a wish to learn, where there is a will to learn, everybody is going to learn. Only the thing is, the little change which has come is now the parents' responsibility is also accumulated with the, you know, teacher's responsibility. Earlier it was that the child has come to school and the work was done, the teachers were taking care of it. But today when we are going online and, you know, dealing with the people, parents are feeling a little bit of trouble, but I think with time they would also adjust. Yeah, so I've got the hand, so I'll close my words here. Yeah, that is what I feel to opine. Yeah, thank you.
Thank you, Neema ma'am. You shared that online has been amazing for you, and virtually you are inside the children's homes. Bond between the teacher and the child is gonna stay forever, that's for sure. Learning must go on via any medium from time to time. If it changes, doesn't make a difference, because the content and the delivery remains the same. Video or virtual classroom, you know, it's the option that somebody feels good with, and parent is now responsible for the child, that's for sure. Lekin parent ki responsibility ke saath mein ek naya challenge aa gaya hai ki pura school jo hai wo transparent ho gaya hai, and every single activity has become scrutinizable now. Aur utni scrutiny jhelne ke liye school shayad taiyar nahi hai, because wo bahut zyada challenging ho gaya kuch schools ke liye. And but yes, this is the time to actually develop the sense of empathy within the whole ecosystem, because only then the ecosystem will exist. Nahi to hum bahut zyada lad lenge shayad. So thank you so much, ma'am, for sharing those amazing thoughts. Next, I would like to invite Manisha Arundekar, Principal, Dr. S. Radhakrishnan International School, Borivali West. Ma'am, over to you. You can unmute your audio.
Yes, hello, good evening, everyone. I feel change is the only constant. That's what the learning from this pandemic. And everyone has got a lot of possibilities to learn with technology. So technology is actually teaching us so much. Okay, the word teaching is always complemented by learning. So I believe everybody has got this opportunity and everybody is making the best out of it. Am I audible?
Yes.
Yeah, okay. So like in this world, few days, last few months, we have seen all teachers, students, everybody has given their best. You know, teachers have found out lot of gadgets. They have used lot of apps to explore that what is the best pedagogy to give it to students. They have worked on different skill sets and everything so that their students will get the best. And on the other hand, like, students have also given their best, you know, they are also receptive, they are also clarifying their doubts. So that is what is making a difference, because both children and teachers, like, you know, both of them, they are maintaining their bond. They are receptive to each other. And that is the beauty of the whole education. I also feel that, you know, in future, like, if we have to go ahead with this, this technology has given us a lot, and we have never thought that, you know, that school, like, we have to run school online. Like, as principal, we never have even thought in our wildest of the dreams that this is home to home service. Education is home to home service. But there is a possibility, and I feel let us look at it as in a positive way. In fact, I feel in future, if we have to run the school, schools can actually focus more on social emotional learning curriculum that can happen in schools, and this academics can be taken care by online. You know, see, like Emma Watson, the famous actress, she said that I don't go to school only to learn academics, but I want to interact with people. I want to learn. I want to associate with people with the same idea. So same things can happen with us as well. And when we reopen schools, I'm sure that we will be doing a lot more things about social emotional curriculum. Let children come to school and have fun with lots of activities. Let them, like, you know, make new friends, manage their stress, deal with their stress, manage their relationship, because that is what is the need of the hour. And today's students are also 21st century learners. So definitely they need to come up with creative ideas. Let them think critically. Let them communicate effectively. Let them, like, you know, collaborate among each other so that they can make a lot of difference, a positive difference in this world. And I feel looking at all these past few months, I feel like technology has taught us a lot. And so when you say, is tech really teaching? I feel yes, definitely it is teaching us a lot and something which is beyond our imagination. Thank you.
Thank you so much, ma'am. Again, to summarize, tech is teaching us a lot right now. And experimentation has taken the front seat. Pedagogy mein bhi, content mein bhi, teacher ke content delivery mein bhi, bahut sara innovation ab aana chalu ho gaya. Children are really receptive to this because wo to tech generation hai. Wo paida hi tech ke saath hue hain, to unke liye koi bahut bada challenge nahi hai. Ye baat zarur hai ki hum unse ek step piche hain. Because wo education ka ek bottom line paradox hamesha se hai ki aap apne se pichli generation se padhte hain. Ek generation aap hote hain aur aap apne se agli ko padhate hain. So there's always a two generation gap between the teacher and the learner. और वो हमेशा ब्रिज करना थोड़ा सा टिपिकल होता है एंड एक बहुत नया कॉन्सेप्ट अब जो जगह पे आई गया है विच इज डोर डिलीवरी ऑफ एजुकेशन कि हर एक के घर के दरवाजे पे जा रही है वो एंड बहुत आसानी से अब मिल भी रही है सोशल इमोशनल लर्निंग के ऊपर फोकस करना एंड इन द फ्यूचर द स्कूल एक्चुअली बिकमिंग अ सेंटर ऑफ एक्सीलेंस फॉर दैट इज समथिंग रियली क्रिटिकल जो एक्चुअली होगा इन द कमिंग टाइम्स एक प्रिंसिपल ने बड़ा अच्छा सा थॉट शेयर किया था कुछ समय पहले दैट जैसे कोविड हैड डिजीज हॉटस्पॉट The school can actually become the immunity hotspot because आपके पास पूरे समाज के सबसे strong brand ambassadors आप ही के पास हैं जो तुरंत किसी भी नए communication को सब तक पहुंचा देंगे So you can actually become the immunity hotspot in the coming times and शायद अब जो teacher का role है that has actually you know enlarged itself अब आप केवल बच्चों को नहीं पढ़ाएंगे अब आप अपने आसपास की पूरी society को पढ़ाएंगे क्योंकि when you talk of social emotional learning तो उसका impact academic से बहुत ज़्यादा बड़ा होता है और सबसे major चीज़ तुरंत होता है And you can see the change around you. Thank you so much, ma'am, for sharing those amazing thoughts. Let's now invite Dr. Dipali Savai, Director City Pride School, Pune. Ma'am, over to you. You can unmute your audio.
So the theme which I have been told that whether technology is really teaching, that was the theme. So if that is a question, my answer would be yes and no both. I will able to like to explain on this. So whenever we say that experience teaches a person or when you get the knowledge, you can solve many problems. But if we actually see there are many people making the same mistakes again and again, they don't apply that knowledge which they have learned. So what I have seen till now is there is knowledge, there is experience. And on the other side, there are problems and applications. But there is a huge wall between these two compartments. And people, many times, they do not apply their knowledge. Now, in this pandemic situation, now we are using Zoom to get connected to people sitting at different places. We actually, this Zoom platform was there since long, but we never felt like using this. There are lot many times meetings we have been conducting with the parents when there is a huge number, we had to conduct it so many times, but we never felt that we can use this platform. And it is not the case that we were not knowing this platform. We have been seeing this kind of platform in news channels. We have been listening to people who are in professional corporates that they have been using this kind of platform. But we were very happy with WhatsApp because that was where we have broken that wall between these two compartments, the knowledge and the problem. We were thinking that textual connection between people amongst us It is possible to just send a text, making a group. It was okay for us that time. If we still go back in late 1980s, computer was there very much here in India. But then still I have seen till 2000, the teachers were still writing in the lesson plan with their hand. They never used a computer. Now that we have understood that this platform is there, we have researched many platforms, and now we can say that for a teacher, not only two qualities are important, that is, first is the knowledge of her subject, second is the skills, teaching skills, the third skill which comes into picture now is the technology. She should be very much aware about the technology, then only the blended learning will be possible. Personalized learning would be possible with the technology. Thank you.
Thank you so much, ma'am. To summarize what all you said, we are making the same mistakes again and again. That's for sure. Because technology ko education ne bahut at a later stage accept kiya, and we have always tried to keep the screen out of the school. But now the school is actually in the screen. And हम लोगों ने बड़ा डिप्लोमेटिकली अपना स्टेटमेंट शिफ्ट भी कर लिया कि सारे बच्चों से कि भाई स्क्रीन पे मत रहिए, स्क्रीन पे कम से कम 6 घंटे रहिए. सो दैट हैज हैपेंड एंड वी हैव यू नो वेरी प्रोफिशिएंटली डन दैट. एंड अभी तक हम टेक्स्ट कम्युनिकेशन से बहुत खुश थे कि भाई टेक्स्ट इज एक्चुअली सॉल्विंग द पर्पस, देन व्हाई टू गो बियॉन्ड टेक्स्ट. हम ऑडियो विजुअल तक अभी आए नहीं थे, बट अब हम आ गए क्योंकि ये आप ही हम मर्जी से नहीं आए, ये एक्चुअली फोर्स अपॉन कर दिया गया और इतना बड़ा चेंज एकदम फट से आ गया. जो एडटेक अगर नॉर्मल सिनेरियो में अगले 10 साल में ग्रो करता, वो शायद चंद दिनों में ग्रो कर गया, शायद पहले लॉकडाउन के 10 दिनों में ही ग्रो कर गया. दैट एवरीबडी अडेप्टेड टू टेक वेरी क्विकली. एंड एक बात सही है कि टीचर्स को एक नया स्किल सेट चाहिए, एंड वो स्किल सेट में टेक्नोलॉजी इनेबलमेंट एक पार्ट है. एंड एक पार्ट दैट वी कुड फील वॉज कॉन्टेंट में भी मेजर रिवैम्प चाहिए, बिकॉज कॉन्टेंट जो हम अभी पढ़ा रहे हैं वो कुछ कुछ जगह पे अपनी रेलिवेंस पूरी तरीके से खो चुका है. It actually now needs to be revamped according to the need of the next generation ki employability. Kyunki wo abhi koi nahi dekh raha hai. Hum log keval padha rahe hain. Hum ye nahi dekh rahe ki hum kya padha rahe hain. To us kya ke upar ek bahut bada question hai. Content curriculum needs to be rethought. And one more aspect. Aap apne teacher ko jab, ya bachcha apne teacher ko jab is screen pe dekh raha hota hai, ye charo taraf se jo band screen hai hamare, wo aapko kisi bhi celebrity se compare kar raha hota hai. एंड आपकी कंटेंट डिलीवरी उसी के एस्पेक्ट से जज की जा रही होती है और वो उस समय पे हमेशा फेल हो जाती है. तो प्रेजेंटेशन स्किल्स अब एक बहुत बड़ा एस्पेक्ट हो जाएगा टीचिंग का, बिकॉज यू आर इन फ्रंट ऑफ द कैमरा. तो कैमरा स्किल्स बहुत क्रिटिकल होने वाली इन द कमिंग टाइम्स. सो थैंक यू सो मच मैम. आई वुड नाउ लाइक टू इन्वाइट मिस्टर नीरज सिन्हा, प्रिंसिपल फिरायाला पब्लिक स्कूल रांची झारखंड. सर ओवर टू यू, यू कैन अनम्यूट योर ऑडियो.
Okay, I'm just taking the whole scenario from 24th of March. I mean, prior to that, we were into different mindset. We were the one who provokes the student not to use mobile and other things. But now whole system is into the mobile. Use of technology for teaching and other things had brought something which is really very unique. I mean, as a principal, as a leader of the school, I was the one who used to observe the teachers, the classes, how it is happening. But now the parents are also there to see that what type of teaching is happening. So initially from 24th of March, I went with all those study course material to the student, giving them into soft notes. But within 2 weeks, the parents started requesting, no, sir, please, we should have online classes. And after searching a lot, I came to Avaya or Google Classroom at present. So I trained my teacher also, because the teachers were not so smart enough to go for this technology, because we were hiring a whiteboard also and green board also. But you being a principal, you also should observe that mostly they use the green board or the blackboard. Very rarely they go to use this whiteboard with any presentation. But now it has the demand and there's a requirement of the time. So mostly the teacher had switched over, and within the advent of time, within a week or a two, they became very smart. Their content was really very interesting. So I also had a time to interact with the teachers through the app and train them that whatever you are teaching should be out of the box. I mean, if you go with the traditional teaching as you are doing in the class, you might be able to trap the student, but here you are not able, and you are not going to ask them all the time, are you understanding or not? So your teaching should be out of the box, something very innovative, very interesting. There should be some interest in the student. So I put a strong hold on the attendance of the student also, the strength of the classes also, and slowly it had come up from 70% to 83%. Now when this had happened, ultimately the student started taking interest. Now when you talk about the technology, earlier if you take once in a month or twice in a month parent orientation, parent feels very bad. Arey sir, you are calling. Now in the technology, I can decide one day, Sunday, and I can have a orientation with the parents every half an hour class-wise. So the response of the parent is also very happy. The parent themselves say, no, we understand how difficult my child was there in the class, because when I'm sitting in front of a mobile and feeling restless. So it's a two-way game. Learning is happening in a much better way than in class. That is my thought process. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Neeraj sir. And आपने दो तीन चीजें बहुत ही अच्छी बोली कि दैट पेरेंट्स आर नाउ ऑब्जर्विंग द स्कूल विद द स्कूल लीडर एंड पेरेंट्स के अंदर भी वो थोड़ी सी एम्पैथी बिल्ड होनी शुरू हो गई कि हाँ यार इतना आसान नहीं था एंड मैं जितने क्वेश्चंस कर रहा था उनके जवाब भी इतने आसान नहीं थे एंड सेकेंडली सॉफ्ट नोट्स से वर्चुअल क्लासरूम एंड एक बड़ा इंपॉर्टेंट चीज है एक मैं एक्चुअली उन प्रिंसिपल ने बड़ा अच्छा एक स्टेटमेंट पोर्ट किया था कि फ्रॉम राइटिंग ऑन द सैंड टू अ ब्लैक बोर्ड टू अ ग्रीन बोर्ड टू अ व्हाइट बोर्ड एंड फाइनली टू अ वर्चुअल बोर्ड इसमें जो पहले बोर्ड्स का ट्रांजिशन था वो बहुत धीरे धीरे हुआ लेकिन वर्चुअल बोर्ड पे 10 दिन के अंदर ट्रांजिशन हो गया और इसीलिए वो हैंडल उतना आसानी से नहीं हो रहा था बट टीचिंग आउट ऑफ द बॉक्स इज आप टीचिंग पेडागोजी और टीचिंग की कंटेंट डिलीवरी जो है वो पूरी तरीके से रिवैम्प हो गई है जिसपे वी नीड मोर ट्रेनिंग राइट नाउ अटेंडेंस सभी स्कूलों के अंदर ग्रेजुअली धीरे धीरे ऊपर गई जब बच्चों को इंटरेस्ट आना शुरू हुआ दे कुड गेट हुक्ड टू अ वर्चुअल क्लासरूम एंड यस पेरेंट ओरिएंटेशन एवरी संडे तो आई शुड थिंक अब हर स्कूल के अंदर एक CRM डिपार्टमेंट अलग से हो जाए जो कि केवल कस्टमर रिलेशनशिप मैनेजमेंट करे बिकॉज अब आपकी पूरा प्रोसेस जो है वो एब्सोल्यूट ट्रांसपेरेंट है सो देयर इज अ लॉट मोर नीड फॉर टॉकिंग ओरिएंटेशन इंडक्शंस दैट्स समथिंग दैट वी नीड वेरी रेगुलरली थैंक यू सो मच नीरज सर लेट्स नाउ लिसन इट फ्रॉम नेहा केसी मैम डायरेक्टर अक्षरा स्कूल काठमांडू नेपाल मैम ओवर टू यू यू कैन अनम्यूट योर ऑडियो
Thank you so much. Namaste, everyone. I'm Neha from Akshara School. I would like to thank Ablav for this opportunity. Actually, I couldn't make it last time. So, you all shared, it's been a great, looking at the brighter side, it's been a great opportunity. Like my school had been using G Suite from a long, long time, but then it's now when we've been able to use the most of the elements that they provide. So I think it's very, very nice thing that we are learning. And I think, look at us, if we were not up to tech, it would not have been possible to be sharing things like that. We as educators, as principals, as directors, we are in this situation. That means how important it was for teachers. And the other brighter side I would like to talk about is now with this, the gap between the teachers around the world is coming closer because like they all are IT friendly now. And since it's been a great challenge to be dealing with the techno kids, they all are techno kids because they all are millennial kids. We at least had to learn after a certain time regarding this thing, but then they were born with that. So I think if we talk about teachers, yes, tech is teaching because this has made teachers more self-assured because it might not have been their cup of tea, but then like sir said, it's now within 10 days they've learned and they are passing on it to the students and they've been able to do remote learning, replacing face-to-face learning. They're able to use various online tools, not only one, but then so many, and they're digging into things so mitigate way. And I think this COVID-19 has unknowingly created an opportunity, especially for teachers, where they were forced, let's say positively, to learn ICT skills. It has further helped them to build their own communities, to share and enrich teaching resources with the help of collaborating as well. So it's been quite useful. And I think when we come back to the physical classroom, the good thing that is going to happen is like obviously we'll have to reschedule our calendars and we'll have to deduct all the holidays. So during winter break or during festivals break, we can continue this online learning. I'm not sure about India, but then often like here in Nepal, sometimes there are strikes and something. And even during that case, this online can be used and teacher can continue teaching. And knowingly, unknowingly, parents are observing from home, and which is a good thing because previously we were tired of telling them. But now since they are observing from home themselves, they know the school is giving much more than what they had said. So it's a very good opportunity for parents to observe and see, and we to prove that the school is really working hard. So I think, yes, the tech is really teaching, looking at the brighter side. The teachers and educators have come a way ahead. This is it. Thank you.
Thank you, Neha ma'am. To summarize again what you said, that you were using G Suite for a long time, but yes, now you're completely using it, uske sare features ke saath mein, because now we're actually using all those features. And gap between the global teachers is finally finishing off, which is going to be a very big change in the coming times because best practices bahut aasani se percolate ho sakengi and we'll be able to practice them across boundaries. And remote learning is now acceptable, jo abhi tak thi hi nahi. एंड फोर्स ट्रेनिंग ऑफ टीचर्स से सेल्फ मोटिवेटेड टीचर ट्रेनिंग हो गई है बिकॉज टीचर्स नो दैट वी हैव टू अपस्किल आवरसेल्व्स नहीं तो इररिलेवेंट हो जाएंगे एंड स्कूल परफॉर्मेंस हैज फाइनली बीन प्रूव्ड तो पेरेंट के सामने द स्कूल हैज फाइनली अराइव्ड दैट यस वी आर देयर वी आर डूइंग ग्रेट थिंग्स एंड पेरेंट ने भी वो एक्सेप्ट कर लिया कि हाँ स्कूल इज एक्चुअली वर्किंग अ लॉट ऑफ मार्केट सो आई वुड नाउ रिक्वेस्ट डॉक्टर संजय मेहता फाउंडर कंट्रीसाइड इंटरनेशनल स्कूल सूरत गुजरात सर ओवर टू यू यू कैन अनम्यूट योर ऑडियो
Yeah, congratulations, Daksh and your team. And I must compliment the person who has given the topic. It's very tricky. I mean, as Dipali ma'am, she has rightly said that either yes or no, both the answer could be there. So it's a rhetorical question statement. But one thing I would like to say that, technology can change the world. And it has changed the school or education system, which we were looking since long. There is one slok in Sanskrit, samyak sarati iti samsarah. That is in Mahabharat, Bhagavan Krishna, Lord Krishna, he said that the entire universe is like a flow. So it's a constant change, and this change is expected every time. So today, what we are talking about, it is not about today, we are talking about tomorrow. Like we are teaching today to those kids who are going in the world where 68% jobs will get replaced or either will get destroyed after 15 years. All repetitive tasks which is being done by human beings will be changed or will take place by machines. So we are preparing them for future. And I think the real challenge is this. Till now we are teaching or we were teaching reading, writing, speaking skills, social emotional skills, that is fine. But now students will have to understand and learn a new language, not only teachers, but students also. And that is language of technology, that is coding. I mean, I may sound a bit weird, but from grade 5, grade 6, they must understand the language of technology, that is coding and then programming, because the future is this. So I think it's all about combination of techie and fussy. So both kind of skills. Techie, that means who are masters of technology, who can use this day-to-day technology in life, in professional life. And fussy, those people who are highly creative and then have got collaborative skills, create something new, can think something out of box. So for teachers and students, it will be a combination of both kind of skills, and that will be badly required. Technology identifies the need of the time or need of the society, but ultimately we are the people who utilize it. And today the need in COVID need is online teaching, and that has been fulfilled by Zoom or G Suite or Google Meet. And we are using it. And somebody has rightly said that, within 10 days, everything is on, switch, like on computer, and we could change it. Now, $1 billion question is whether technology be replacing teachers or not. And here I can give my firm statement that is no. I can say that no, teachers cannot be replaced by technology, but yes, of course, those teachers, techno-savvy teachers, can replace ordinary teachers. So it's a change.
Thank you so much, right? Sajid. So, the time is actually over.
I mean, technology will be.
Thank you so much. So again, to summarize what all you said, that universe is typically a constant flow and change is happening. 68% jobs will be taken up by tech. That's for sure. क्योंकि जितने भी जॉब्स में रिडंडेंसी है रिपीटेटिवनेस है वो सारे टेक्नोलॉजी बहुत आसानी से कर लेगी एंड वी नीड टू लर्न द लैंग्वेज ऑफ टेक कोडिंग अब बहुत क्रिटिकल होने वाली इन द कमिंग टाइम्स एंड आपने शायद एक टेक्नोलॉजी लैंग्वेज में ही एक दिस आई थिंक इंजीनियरिंग के कोर्स के अंदर एक बुक होती है फजी लॉजिक आपने उसी की टर्म उठा के टेक एंड फजी का कॉम्बो बता दिया एंड एब्सोल्युटली इट्स राइट कि अब थोड़ा सा टेक्नोलॉजी थोड़ी सी क्रिएटिविटी यही दोनों चाहिए तभी जाके यू कैन क्रिएट अ ह्यूमन बीइंग हु विल बी रिलेवेंट एंड एम्प्लॉयबल इन द कमिंग टाइम्स सो थैंक यू सो मच संजय सर फॉर शेयरिंग दोज अमेजिंग थॉट्स आई वुड नाउ रिक्वेस्ट Ms. Bindu Joseph, Principal, MKH, Sancheti Public School and Junior College, Nagpur. Ma'am, over to you. You can unmute your audio.
Well, namaste and good evening to everyone.
Thank you, Daksh, and the team of Blub World for giving me an opportunity to share my view on this platform. Well, during this time when we all as an educators and school leaders are totally relying on the so-called tech-enabled platform for continuing the process of teaching and learning, this question, is tech really teaching? I think which is posed by Blub World is quite authentic. Well, it would be very irrelevant if I will say no, tech is not really teaching, because I personally feel it's only because of this technology we are connected to our student and we are able to teach our student from last 3 months. Well, having said this, I would like to bring before this forum an experiment which was conducted nearly 21 years back by Mr. Sugata Mitra, well known for his book School in the Cloud. And that experiment was for having the answer for the same question, can technology teach? And his experiment of hole in the wall is a big proof that children can be taught very.
I would now request Ms. Akhila Dinesh, Principal, Radcliffe School, Khargar, Mumbai, to take the next 2 minutes. And then we'll again go back to Bindu ma'am. Bindu ma'am, you were disconnected from the call. We'll come back to you after listening to Akhila ma'am.
Very good evening to all the eminent panelists over here. And I would like to take this opportunity to congratulate the Blub World for organizing such a wonderful educational platform where all of us as educators can share and express our ideas on online teaching. Now, lockdown in response to COVID-19 has shalted us very badly. And especially us as educators, we had to redefine and we had to reinvent our school ecosystem. Now, when I had say over here that we have to reinvent, I basically want to emphasize what all of you had told. The most important stakeholder of the schools, that is the students, they had to undergo a drastic change. The classrooms now had become their home. Their books were now their screen, their teachers were now their parents, and of course, the friends had completely disappeared from the scenario. Now, all this had prompted the school to bring them online modules or online teaching practices, which will see to it that the students are engaged to maximum. Now, if my school is a CBSE school, which runs on a pedagogy and which is the basis of the pedagogy is experiential learning. Now, many of the activities which are being done in the classroom cannot be done in the case when you're teaching online. So major challenge that we approach or we have is to completely replace the traditional classroom setup to an online classroom. Now, basically, when we see about activities which are conducted, we had to completely restructure the activities. The activities should be completely performed online to make the students more engaging. Now, one of the example I would like to say is the kitchen is one of the origin of STEM education, where majority of experiments can be conducted, like, you know, thermal conductivity, maybe classification, maybe organization. So variety of things. So these sort of activities can be structured and can be delivered to the students. Now, next important thing which I would like to mention over here is, even I as a person have a very less concentration period. You know, if the teachers go on teaching, the concentration span of the students is very less. Now, how do we engage the students? It's very important for all the schools, which even my school had done, to engage in a lot of student engagement tools. Now, there are a lot of ice-breaking sessions in between. Of course, the timetables do have a transition period. Apart from that, we have a lot of apps like Kahoot and a lot of other apps, which are like, you know, wherein a lot of games and simulation, educational things can be provided, which can be completely planned and provided to students. So it's very much essential to have a break, whether it is a physical or a virtual break in the screen time, which will help the students to come back to the class and not, you know, the attendance level of the school, the students in the class can be increased. So this is another thing. Most important thing that my school had done, and which is basically the 10th and 12th both students, they are undergoing a lot of crisis because they are going to write the board exams. There's a lot of anxiety, there's a lot of pressure. Now here, the core members, of course, teachers are counselors, but the core members of the team, that is the principals, headmistress, and the coordinators, we came out with an adoption program wherein we adopted few children who are needy, and constant mentoring and counseling was given so that the anxiety and pressure in these board, those students who are writing board examination, was reduced. So this is one more thing. Now, after all, when I speak about the entire pedagogy, entire online pedagogy, if it is not transacted properly, if the process owners, that is the teachers, they are not equipped, then there is no point in the complete planning or complete reach.
The time was actually over, but yes, you made some amazing points, and I'll try to recapture them again for everybody, all the audience here. Students went for a drastic change, and very quickly. A lot of experiential learning, जो अभी ऑनलाइन क्लासेज में पॉसिबल नहीं हो पा रही थी, which is typically the pedagogy for most of the CBSE schools. And एक बहुत अच्छा पॉइंट आपने शेयर किया that the kitchen is the actual and the real tinkering lab, जो अब स्कूल्स में हो गई है कि जहाँ पे बहुत सारे एक्सपेरिमेंटेशन बहुत आसानी से हो सकते हैं. And attention span जो है वो बहुत क्रिटिकल है, एंड उस अटेंशन स्पैन के ऊपर ही अब बहुत सारा काम चाहिए, बिकॉज ओनली एजुकेशन वोंट कीप योर स्टूडेंट्स स्टिक टू कॉन्टेंट, थोड़ा सा एंटरटेनमेंट फैक्टर भी चाहिए. तो टिपिकली वॉट यूल नीड इज एड्यूटेनमेंट, थोड़ा सा एजुकेशन, थोड़ा सा एंटरटेनमेंट, एंड उसको स्टिकी बनाना इज नाउ व्हाट्स मोर रेलेवेंट, बिकॉज अटेंशन स्पैन सच में बच्चों का बहुत छोटा है. एंड कंटिन्यूअस ब्रेक्स ड्यूरिंग ऑनलाइन क्लासेस हैज वर्क्ड वंडर्स फॉर स्कूल्स. ये हमने इतने लोगों से बात करके वी कुड वेरी इजीली अंडरस्टैंड कि हर क्लास के बाद थोड़ा थोड़ा ब्रेक एक्चुअली मेक्स देम वेरी एक्टिव. एंड आप क्लास के बीच में भी शायद, जैसे एक आगरा में एक स्कूल है, उन्होंने बहुत अच्छा एक्सपेरिमेंट किया था. दे डिड टाइम्ड असाइनमेंट्स कि आपको क्लास में पहले फ्लिप लर्निंग का दे टोल्ड द टॉपिक, एंड देन द स्टूडेंट्स वर गिवन 10 मिनट्स कि 10 मिनट में आप रिसर्च कीजिए, एंड द नेक्स्ट 5 मिनट्स यू प्रेजेंट इट. एंड वो 10-10 मिनट के टास्क देके दे कंप्लीट ध्यान चाहिए. So this is a very good approach to handle it. Thank you so much, ma'am. So Bindu ma'am, again, over to you. You can unmute your audio.
Once again, thank you. See, this is the challenge which we face usually during our online classes, also the connectivity issue, which I've also faced now, maybe because of the environment and maybe because of the connectivity issue is also there. Well, I was quoting about the experiment conducted by Mr. Sugata Mitra nearly 21 years back. And it's a proof that technology can make study easy. And we all have to adapt it. And technology is not something which we were not using actually. Then why this question is coming out now is, so what I was saying is technology is not something new, which is we all were using this technology in one or the other way in our physical classrooms also. But now it's a big question for everybody is posing this question, will technology will be able to teach or not? It may be because during this period of pandemic, we all have totally dependent on the technology, and we can see a paradigm shift from sage on the stage to guide on the site. But I would like to say, whatever may be the circumstances, the role and importance of teacher can never be replaced by technology. Technology can be used as a tool. Technology, when used properly, it can bring a drastic revolution in the way the learning happens in the classrooms. Obviously, the emotional touch, the values of the confidence, the value of composer, all these needs a human touch, which never a technology can do on its own. But still, we should not forget that we are teaching a generation which is growing with smartphones and internet. And as an educators, it's our need that we should inculcate the technology in our pedagogical tools also. And it's a time when we have opened up completely for the technology because of this crisis. So let's not consider it as a temporary phase. Rather, let's be resilient and be in an adaptive mode. And let's shift to the blended learning version, blended teaching version. Make our teachers technology savvy. And we should develop our professional development of the teacher is the need of the hour. They all should become technology savvy. And it's a time that we should understand that now the classrooms are not teacher-centric. We have to shift towards the student-centric classroom. That's all I would like to say. Let's adapt to this new normal of blended and flipped learning. Thank you.
थैंक यू सो मच बिंदु मैम. टोटली रिलाइंग ऑन टेक टू टीच, ये भी एब्सोल्युटली हो गया जो आपने पहले बोला था. स्कूल इन अ क्लाउड बाय सुगाता मित्रा एंड होल इन द वॉल, ये दोनों प्रोजेक्ट्स बहुत अच्छे से एक्सपेरिमेंट भी हुए, काम भी किए, बट आई थिंक इन पे ध्यान अब जा रहा है लोगों का, बिकॉज दिस इज व्हेन वी हैड टू एक्चुअली एक्सपेरिमेंट विद दीज थिंग्स. अभी तक वो किया नहीं गया था. अभी तक हम कॉन्टेंट को पेडागोजी समझते थे और पेडागोजी को करिकुलम समझते थे. अब बहुत लोगों को ये चीज क्लियर हुई है कि ये सब अलग अलग साइलोज हैं और सारे अलग अलग हैं और सब पे अलग अलग काम करना पड़ता है एंड इन सब की अलग अलग ट्रेनिंग चाहिए. सो दिस इज वेयर यू नो अ लॉट ऑफ इनोवेशन विच हैपेंड इज राइट नाउ बीइंग यूज्ड एंड लेट्स प्रिपेयर फॉर अ टेक इनेबल्ड फ्यूचर, दैट्स फॉर श्योर, बिकॉज टेक इज हियर टू स्टे. वी डोंट थिंक एंड हम शायद किसी को भी ऐसा नहीं लगता है कि नाउ इट्स गोना गो ऑफ. अब एड टेक इज पार्ट ऑफ एड एंड वील हैव टू फाइंड आउट वेज टू यू नो इनेबल इट इन अ वे दैट इट डजंट हर्ट एनीबडी इन द होल इकोसिस्टम. आई थिंक यू ऑल एंजॉयड द लास्ट 20-30 मिनट्स दैट यू स्पेंड विद अस. And before this talk comes to an end, because mota mota we've heard everybody who's there on the call, I like to leave everybody with some food for thought so that when we meet next, there's something more interesting to talk about. So every section of the society contributes to society with its own capabilities, experiences, understandings, and perceptions. And this is the time when the farmers have been taking care of our food, police has been taking care of security, doctors have been taking care of our health. As educationists, we just got our one new duty. एंड वो एक नई ड्यूटी जो अभी अभी एड हो गई है हम लोगों के काम में टूवर्ड्स द सोसाइटी इज टू टिपिकली बिल्ड द नॉलेज बैंक दैट द वर्ल्ड वुड नीड इन द फ्यूचर. बिकॉज वॉट यू कैन ऑब्जर्व राइट नाउ अराउंड यू, नोबडी एल्स कैन डू इट. सो स्टार्ट बिल्डिंग अ हैबिट ऑफ राइटिंग एन ऑब्जर्वेशन पेपर एवरी सिंगल इवनिंग कि एजुकेशन आपकी चारों तरफ कैसे बदल रही है. बिकॉज ये जो डॉक्यूमेंटेशन आप अभी करेंगे, ये फ्यूचर जनरेशन ढूंढेंगे कि भाई जब ऐसा हुआ था तो वॉट वर पीपल डूइंग. And these observations would become the basis for innovation in the coming times. Because you are practitioners, aap log research scholars nahi hai ki aap roz hi likhenge, but haan, as practitioners, ab ye nayi duty aa gayi hai because environment itna jaldi change ho ja raha hai ki hum usse pace nahi rakh pa rahe. And aage aane wale samay mein, this is going to be the reality again and again. So this is the time to build knowledge. To knowledge banana chalu kar dijiye as practitioners right now. बिकॉज बहुत सारे इनपुट्स चाहिए होंगे तब जाके एजुकेशन स्ट्रीमलाइन हो पाएगी. सो आई थिंक दिस इज द टाइम दैट यू ऑल विल बिकम द क्रिटिकल रिसोर्स फॉर नॉलेज एंड नॉलेज शेयरिंग इन द वर्ल्ड. एंड हम सबको एक चीज ये समझनी चाहिए कि एज फार एज एजुकेशन इज कंसर्न, हमें पूरी दुनिया एज अ लेबोरेटरी तैयार मिल गई है इन अ कंट्रोल्ड एटमोसफियर कि आप जो एक्सपेरिमेंट करना चाहें वो कर सकते हैं और उसके तुरंत इन्फ्लुएंसेस निकाल सकते हैं. सो दिस इज द टाइम टू टेस्ट पेडागोजी, दिस इज द टाइम टू एक्सपेरिमेंट. This is the time to know what new can be done. Because duniya mein aisa bahut kam baar hota hai jab society as a whole gets receptive ki har change ko wo accept karne ki sthiti mein aa jati hai. Kyunki maximum time society resist karti hai. To abhi aapko wo resistance nahi milega, abhi receptiveness milega. So try to experiment as much as you can and share those experiments with everybody who's around you. Even we are publishing some of the best observation papers that people have shared with us. So try to write an observation paper every single evening. I hope you enjoyed the last 20-30 minutes. If you did, and if you want to attend the future sessions, you can open your audio, say a big yes, and thank you so much, people, for attending the Blub World Web Talks 61st episode. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Definitely, we would like to
thank you.
Join.
Thank you.
Thank you.